Hello friends, welcome to Tutorials Point. In this video, we will introduce you to Swift Loops. The concept of executing a block of code multiple times is known as loop. In Swift, there are three types of loop currently, which are for in loop, while loop, and repeat while loop. Previous versions of Swift had for loops, which included for loop also, but in Swift 4, for loop has been removed. Now, let us see an implementation of for in loop. This loop iterates over a collection of values where for is a keyword, any variable is any variable that you can declare, in is a keyword, and collection of values is any collection of values, inside which we will write the code that we want to execute multiple times. Now, let us see while loop. While loop executes a code until the condition is satisfied. For example, the format of while loop is while condition, and inside the braces we write the code that we want to execute. Now let us see a repeat while loop. In repeat while loop, a block of code executes until a condition is satisfied. In repeat while, the code of statement is executed at least once before checking the condition. Now let us see the syntax of this repeat while loop. In repeat while loop, first we write the code to be executed, after which we check the condition. So at least once the code will be executed before checking the condition. Now let us see practically the implementation of all these loops in our playground. In this example, we have created a Swift file having all the type of loops. In the first line, we are declaring a variable num with value 5. After that, this is a comment line. Comments are ignored by the compiler, so whatever you write inside this will be ignored. In the next line, we are using a for keyword. This is a for in loop. So to write a for in loop, we'll write the for keyword followed by a variable, then in keyword followed by the range. So this is the one way of declaring a range in which we write the lower value followed by three dots followed by the upper value. So our range will be from 0 to the num variable. So num is 5. So in this example, our range will be 0 to 5. So inside this we have written print for loop including both values and then backslash bracket z. This is done to print a variable value inside the print statement. So the result for this first for loop will be for loop including both values. So this is printing the same statement that we have written, for loop including both values slash z. So the first value given to z is 0, that is printed here. After that, after printing this line, the loop will go back to the value of z. So currently the value of z is less than num, so after 0 it will go to 1, then it will print 1, after that it will print 2, 3, 4, and finally it will print the num value, that is 5. So for loop including both values 5. So this is the final output of our for in loop. After this, now we will see a for in loop again, but in this example we are ignoring the upper value. So in this one the range was from 0 to num, but in this one the range is from 0 to less than num, that is it is ignoring the upper value but it is taking the lower value. Similar to our first example, this will also print from 0 to less than num. So from 0 to 4 it should print in this loop. The result for this loop is for loop ignoring upper value, for loop ignoring upper value 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. So it is ignoring the value of num, that is it is not printing 5, it is just printing from 0 to 4. After completing for loops, now we'll go to while loop. This is our while loop. Now in this line we have declared a variable x and we have given a value 3 to it. After that we are checking while x is less than 5. So whenever x is less than 5, the code inside this braces will be executed. So first we are printing while loop and the value of x. So currently the value of x is 3. So it should print 3. After that it will increment the value of x by 1.
So this is called short end. In this, what we have done is we have stored the value of x plus 1 inside x only. So this is this statement, x plus equals to 1. This means x equals to x plus 1. So after executing this line, x will become 4. Again, it will go back to this condition, and now it will check if x is less than 5. So the current value of x is 4. So 4 is less than 5, so it will again execute the same code. After printing the value of x, it will again increment the value by 1. So x plus equals to 1 means x equals to x plus 1. That is, x equals to the current value of x is 4, so 4 plus 1. So now the x becomes 5. Again, it will go back to while loop. Again, it will check the condition. X is less than 5. This time the condition is false because 5 is not less than 5. So now it will skip this loop and it will go out of this loop. So inside this loop, it should have printed only 3 and 4. So this is our for loop. Sorry, this is our while loop. So this is our while loop and it has printed 3 and 4. After our while loop, we'll go to repeat while loop. In repeat while loop, a condition is checked after executing the code at least once. So we have declared a variable n equals to 7. Inside repeat, we have written print n. So it will print the value of n, that is 7. Then n minus equals to 1, that is n equals to n minus 1. So the current value of n is 7. So n equals to 7 minus 1, that is 6. Now after executing this, it will check the condition while n is greater than 5. So after executing this line, n is equal to 6. So still 6 is greater than 5. So it will go back to the repeat loop and then again it will print the value of n. So currently n is 6. So it will print 6, then n minus equals to 1, that is n equals to 6 minus 1, and now n becomes 5. So while n is greater than 5, so 5 is not greater than 5, so condition is false. So it will terminate the execution of this program here only. So the result should be 7 and 6, that is 7 and 6. This is all we will do with loops in Swift language. Thank you.